The news that Kate, Princess of Wales, was hospitalized and underwent surgery shocked many. Somehow it always seems that kings and queens, princes and princesses, are much more perfect than mere mortals. But illnesses do not bypass them. Here's an official statement from Buckingham Palace. Her Royal Highness the Princess of Wales was hospitalized yesterday for routine abdominal surgery. The operation was successful, and she is expected to remain in hospital for 10 to 14 days before returning home to continue her recovery. Based on current medical advice, she is unlikely to return to public duties before Easter. The Princess of Wales appreciates the interest this announcement will generate. She hopes that the public will understand her desire to preserve as much normality for her children as possible, and her desire that her personal medical information remain confidential. A few things are important to note here. The surgery is being called elective, and the recovery period is very long. After giving birth, Kate Middleton left the hospital after 6 hours, and here it is said to be 2 weeks, and further recovery until Easter. Also, it was separately reported that it was not oncology. At the same time, it was also reported that His Majesty King Charles is preparing for elective prostate reduction surgery. When I read that, I choked up a little. The royal prostate usually keeps its secrets from Charles is certainly very democratic, but such frankness with his subjects from him, no one expected. And now, notice the difference. The king's planned operation is announced in advance. Kate's operation was announced after the fact. And next, I will give you a number of proofs that this operation was not planned at all, and that something really happened to the Princess of Wales that required emergency intervention. See, the same statement published on the Buckingham Palace website says, "The Princess of Wales wishes to apologize to all concerned that she has to postpone her upcoming appointments. She hopes to recover and return to work as soon as possible." Could it be that if the surgery had actually been planned in advance, appointments would have been made that required a cancellation? The royal aides went on to admit to the press that just over an hour after the news of the Princess of Wales surgery was not ideal and the day was dramatic. They didn't expect to have to rearrange schedules for meetings and events. Can anyone believe that a team of professionals didn't take into account a planned surgery with such a long recovery period? But the fact that had to replace him at some meetings, including with foreign ambassadors, is easy to believe. And when it turned out that both Charles and Kate were out of commission at the same time, and with her, Prince William, who had already announced he would be there for his wife and children during this time, so his events were canceled as well. Aides had to urgently cancel, renegotiate, call and make new schedules. Prince William had already canceled all his events, also didn't know his wife was going to have a scheduled surgery. No, 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 no. In general, it seems to be a serious matter. If the palace PR people persuaded Charles to announce that he suffers from prostate enlargement in order to divert public attention from the diagnosis of the Princess of Wales. Another problem now facing the royal family. In the absence of three senior representatives at once, it is up to the Queen's counselors to step in, and the counselors still include Prince Harry. This is exactly what everyone has been dreading. But since he is out of British territory, the entire burden now falls on the shoulders of Princess Anne, Prince Edward, and his wife. More recently, the Duke of York's daughter, Princess Beatrice, has also been a member of the Councilors, but she too lives mainly in Italy and deals with the affairs of her family and is not among the working members. Once asked if her brother was going to reduce the number of working members of the royal family, Princess Anne replied, "There aren't so many of us that there's anything to reduce," and she is quite right. Now the three counselors will need to divide the duties of the King and Prince and Princess of Wales between them, not to mention that no one has canceled their own. Let's hope Kate recovers as soon as possible. There's no point in discussing her diagnosis. It could be anything, and perhaps in time it will be revealed what happened. Let's just wish her a speedy recovery.